My name is Sheila Nirenberg, and I'm a professor at Weill Medical College, which is part of Cornell University. My lab studies, we work on how the brain processes information, so how it takes information from the outside world and converts it into neural activity, and then how it uses that neural activity to allow you to do things, to see, to hear, to reach for an object, things like that. You have sensory systems that take information, physical energy from the outside world, like patterns of light or sound, and then it has to get converted into a language that the brain can use for processing it to allow you to do things. When you have a retinal degenerative disease, what happens is that the input cells, your photoreceptors, die. And then the interneurons, because they're connected to them, they start to die too. But the ganglion cells remain intact. So the ganglion cells are the output neurons of the retina. They're the ones that form the optic nerve. And so everything depends on them. They're the guys that send the signals onto the brain. So what we worked out was this code so that we could go from an image into these ganglion cell firing patterns. And people had worked this out for very simple images like stripes or checkerboards, but to be able to do it in real time for natural scenes was a really critical part of it. There are many different cell types in the retina, but we're not mimicking what this cell type that does or that does. We've just abstracted what it does with a set of equations. And then we made a prosthetic system that can send it up. The way our device works is that we have a camera and it takes the images in, and then we have this encoder device, and it converts the images in real time into a code, and it's external to the patient, and it sends the code into the ganglion cells. We just jump over all the damaged area and go right to those ganglion cells and get them to send the signals to the brain. It doesn't involve surgery. So it's just an injection into the eye to put this optogenetic protein into their eye, and then everything else is external. So they would just wear glasses that will interact with a protein that's in their eye. The reason it's exciting is it has the potential to bring back, you know, sort of near normal vision because it has the code. And so there's the handshake between what the brain is expecting signals from the eye, and now we can provide them. And so that's the idea. We learn the brain's language, at least for this part, so we can make much more powerful devices. Winning this MacArthur Award has huge impact on it. It's so unbelievably thrilling. It helps me raise money and so that I can do it. Clinical trials just cost money. There's no way around it. It's one of the greatest things that ever happened to me, and it makes things possible.